How many parameters does this neural network have? Well, only 10, because it is equal to number of weights that you see in between the neurons. Imagine a neural network with 175 billion parameters. Well, GPT-3 is the largest neural network ever created by humanity, as of 2020, December at least. Now, when you're talking about neural network, there are different types, right? Convolutional neural network, RNN, and different architectures. GPT-3 is a language model which is suitable for natural language processing needs, which means it can write essays and poems for you. It can answer questions. It can auto-complete the task. You know, if you're using Gmail, you might have noticed you type a few words and it just auto-completes. So GPT-3 can do that. And very importantly, programmers, be aware, GPT can write code. Isn't that sound crazy and scary? GPT-3 was released in May 2020 by OpenAI, which is yet another Elon Musk company. I don't know how many things one person can do in his one life. Elon Musk is everywhere. So OpenAI is something that was started by Elon Musk, and OpenAI has released GPT-3 in May 2020, and they spent $4.6 million to train this single neural network. So it's just think about it as a neural network that was trained days and days on big GPU farm. They spent $4.6 million in terms of GPU resources, electricity bill, and so on. And now they have a trained model, which can be used by different people. It is an invitation-only usage right now. It is in beta phase. But it was trained on 570 gigabytes of text, the text which was crawled from the internet and Wikipedia. So now this neural network has an understanding of that 570 gigabytes of text. It understands the human language, and it can do amazing things such as writing code, writing resumes even, or doing a language translation. So let's look at the demo real quick. When you go to gpt3examples.com website, it has all the different demo applications built by GPT-3 model. So I'm just gonna go over all different applications. See, you can scroll through all this different applications here. So the first one is the most scary one, all the programmers. So let's check this. So here it is writing a code. So see, someone built this demo where in the designer you tell GPT-3 what kind of a mobile app you want to write. So I want to create Instagram type of mobile application, and I just tell GPT-3 that I want to create this application with navigation bar, with a camera icon, photo title, and message icon, and see what it will do for you. Now it is generating the app. So it is doing your work, programmers. See, it built a mobile app. Yes, GPT-3, the neural network, the AI built, wrote a code and built a mobile app. So you scroll through it. See, Instagram type of app. There is a love icon. There is a comment. You can do all of that. All right. So now let's look at the other demo. So here in this demo, you are using a generative media basically. So generative networks are something that generates something. So here, see, if you notice this, I'm telling GPT-3 that generate a profile of a person, and the person should be a young black woman with long hair that works in finance and lives in Boston and loves the cat. So I'll just fast forward this demo. It created this profile on its own. This person is not a real person, it's a synthetic person. When you say person working in finance, and the GPT-3 automatically put this description here. It also put Boston area, and I think there should be loving cat aspect anywhere.
Okay, do you like this job? Do you have a favorite pet? Cat. See? So that's what GPT-3 did for you. And if you know about want to know about generative media, there's a website called Generated Photos, where all these photos are generated by AI. These are not real human beings. You know, they look like real human beings. For example, this person. It's a fake photo generated by AI. And you can like, okay, I want all the female photos, whatever, young adult. So see, you realize like the extent to which this AI is having impact in our life. Like these photos are used as a model photos, or maybe on the website when you need a model photo, you use that. The third demo I have is something where the GPT-3 is becoming a writing assistant almost. You know, you're writing a poem or an essay, and you can ask GPT-3 to write it for you. So here, you are starting with, she looked away from his face and said she was fine. And now Kasim is saying, okay, I am fine. And it is asking GPT-3 to complete remaining sentence and see what happens. So when you click on this, now GPT-3 is using language model and it is predicting what it should write after I am fine. So see, now whatever is written is being written by AI. It's not human written. And you see that it looks like almost like a short story or a poem. So now if you are a writer or poet, you don't know how to write your whole poem probably. You just write one sentence and it will complete the task for you. Then there is this demo of resume builder. So I want to resume my build. I want to build my resume as a software engineer. All I do is I write in a text all my experience. So first I wrote, okay, worked as a software engineer, whatever, in Los Angeles. And it generated this text for me. So see, it understands that when I say from September to present, it knows how to write this. This is probably easy, but let's see. Yeah, you said just said worked as a React.js engineer, and it created this sentence, created in the mobile application for this platform, use technologies such as this. See, so it can write the resume as if any human is writing it. So now you put all your experience one by one and click on generate and see what happens. See, now your resume is created. So if you open your resume, you see your resume is, if you fill in more blocks, you can complete your resume. It can also generate SQL query. So there is this person, Bhavesh, but he has also a nice channel for data science. He built this demo of generating SQL query from GPT-3. So it looks like he has an access of GPT-3 API key. So he used that to import GPT-3. So here you are creating GPT-3 model. And then I just quickly fast forward. You're kind of training the model. You are just giving the sample that when I say print the first three characters of first name, it means this query. Okay. So you give a bunch of examples, and then when you shoot exit query. So now I'm telling GPT-3 that display the lowest salary from worker table, and it will generate an equivalent SQL query for me. So what is the SQL query? Select min salary from worker. It's a valid runnable SQL query, which GPT-3 created from this human language statement. Now you'll wonder, how can I use GPT-3 in my AI application? Well, right now it is in beta state. It is only invitation, only API access. So I joined the waitlist. I have not gotten any response, but somewhere down the road, when you get a response from this, they will issue you an API key. And you can use that API key, how Bhavesh used, like here, see, he used this API key. So using that API key, you can call the neural network, which is GPT-3, and do amazing things. I personally don't feel you need to be scared that, okay, it will take away all the jobs. Well, it will take away a few jobs, but then we humans always have this creative potential
which we can use to do the next big thing in the life. So think about the industrial revolution when it happened, or think about your IT revolution when it happened. There were many jobs in government offices, tax offices, where, you know, there were people bookkeeping the records, human records, in not in pen, and those jobs were taken away by computers. But now we have new jobs, which is computer programmers, data analyst, QA, RP executive, so many new jobs. So humans have a tendency to optimize some workflow, and once it is optimized, they give it to computer, and then we move on to doing a next big thing, okay? So the idea here is that after learning about GPT-3, maybe you should keep yourself up to date with the latest technology and try to always learn new skills. Never stop learning, okay? You should be a lifelong registered student. Even if you're old, just keep on learning, and we together can create a better future. I hope you like this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends so they know what's happening latest in the world of AI.